I never make a lot of changes after we've lost. I don't usually plan in advance. So it's not to say those guys are the scapegoats, please, I want to put it on record. Usually when we didn't play well and lose a game, you try and keep the same team so they must go and fix it. That's why I kept the same 23. Believe it or not, you are going to lose games, even if you're South Africa. All credit must go to Ireland. So, you know, we really focus on our own game. We weren't happy. I thought we actually, one of the strange games, we won everything except on the scoreboard, but that, you know, that doesn't count for anything. You know, there was no complacency whatsoever. We always knew Ireland's a quality side. They were really probably unlucky not to be the All Blacks, so they're a quality side. I think we're always nervous when we play England, but I think you should put those nerves in excitement. You know, you can't just play every single game and play with emotion. That must be excitement. You must be passionate to go out there and play for your country. And, you know, without giving out the wrong message there, you don't have to motivate the guys when they play England, because they know it's a huge challenge and they know it's unbelievable, you know, heritage going back so many years, and they know Twickenham is one of the most difficult places to play in. So, you know, this week I don't have to say anything. I don't have to motivate the players. I knew they're going to be motivated. It's just my observation is that what happens now doesn't have a big influence on the World Cup. In a sense, it's almost better that you've lost, because now you, like, your guys know they have to step up. It's a one-off in a World Cup playoff, and they, I'm not saying we must lose on Saturday, I'm just saying, so you can't, there's so many nuances, you can't say, you know, because we've won here now, you've got an edge, it's going to happen next time, because then you get complacent. For me, the World Cup is a total different thing.